All right, everyone, get ready, because today on TechnoU, we are diving headfirst into the world of USB 4.
So buckle up, or perhaps plug in.
Right. We're going to unpack why this new tech is causing such a stir.
Yes, there's a lot of buzz, that's for sure.
I mean, 40 Gbps speeds, that's insane. Charging your laptop with the same cable you use for data? Yeah. Sign me up.
USB 4, it's pretty remarkable stuff.
No more cable clutter, some crazy fast transfers, and your laptop charging in a flash. What's not to love, right?
It does seem like a win-win.
So let's break this down. What exactly is USB 4? What makes it so different from, you know, regular old USB?
Well, it's not just a speed upgrade. It's like a whole new way of thinking about connectivity. Officially launched in 2019, it actually builds upon the Thunderbolt 3 technology.
Oh, interesting. So is that why everyone's saying it so fast?
That's definitely a factor. But the real game changer here is the unification of multiple protocols into a single standard.
Okay, in English, please.
Basically, it means data, video, power, all seamlessly flowing through one tiny little USB Type-C connector.
Hold on. So you're telling me that one cable can handle everything? My monitor, my external hard drive, charging, my laptop, all with just one cable?
You got it. It's about simplifying our tech lives, making things more streamlined and efficient. And yeah, that single cable concept is a big part of the appeal.
I could definitely see the appeal. I mean, no more digging through that dreaded cable drawer, trying to find the right one for each device.
Exactly. And when you factor in those 40 gigabits per second data transfer rate, well, let's just say things are about to get a lot faster.
40 gigabits per second? Can you even put that into perspective for me?
Okay, imagine downloading a full-length 4K movie in less than a minute.
Whoa, that's mind-blowing. So we've got the speed, but what about power? Can this one little cable really handle charging power-hungry devices too?
Oh, absolutely. We're talking up to 240 watts of power delivery. Enough juice to charge even the most demanding laptops out there.
No more lugging around those clunky power bricks.
You got it. Picture this, powering a high-resolution external display while simultaneously using it for, say, video editing, all through that same USB-C port.
Okay, that's pretty impressive. This is making me think about all those times I've been held back by incompatible cables or just not having enough ports. Is this really the end of all that frustration?
It certainly has that potential. But one question a lot of people have is, what about all our older devices? Will they work with USB 4?
Right, because what good is all this new tech if it means we have to replace everything we own?
Well, that's the beauty of it. Backwards compatibility is baked right into USB 4. It works with older versions like USB 3.2, 3-2-4-2, and even Thunderbolt 3-R.
Phew, that's a relief. So I don't need to panic and throw out all my old gadgets just yet?
Not at all. And the fact that the USB Type-C connector itself is becoming the industry standard means you're pretty much future-proofed either way.
Okay, so I'm not gonna lie, I'm starting to get pretty excited about this, but let's break down the benefits for the average person. What does this actually mean for someone like me or anyone listening?
Well, let's start with the obvious. Speed. Think about transferring massive video files, downloading games in a flash, or backing up your entire photo library in a fraction of the time it takes now.
I mean, time is money, right?
Absolutely, and speaking of streamlining, let's talk about power delivery. Imagine a world with fewer bulky power adapters cluttering your workspace, one cable to rule them all, charging your laptop, powering your external hard drive, maybe even running your monitor. So,
okay, I'm sold. That sounds like a dream come true.
It's getting closer every day.
I'm starting to see how USB 4 could really change the game.
For sure, it's definitely a technology to keep your eye on.
All right, so we've covered the basics, but the article mentioned different implementations of USB 4.
Ah, yes.
What exactly does that mean? Like, are there different versions or something? And how does it affect, you know, us regular folks?
That's a great question. And it's an important point to clarify. You're right. There are different levels of USB 4, each with its own set of capabilities and performance characteristics.
So not all USB 4s are created equal.
Precisely. Think of it like choosing an internet plan. Some offer blazing fast speeds, while others are more shall we say, budget-friendly access.
Okay, I'm starting to see the picture. So what are we looking at here? What are the different levels of USB4?
Well, there's a baseline level, we call it USB4 Gen 2.1, which offers a respectable data transfer rate of 20 Gbps.
20 Gbps? That's still double the speed of USB 3.2, right?
You got it. It's a significant jump in performance, even at the entry level.
Okay, that's pretty impressive. But you mentioned different levels, so what else is out there?
If you're looking for the top-of-the-line experience, there's USB 4 Gen 3.2, which basically doubles the data lanes and pushes the speed up to that full 40 Gbps we were drooling over earlier.
Ah, so that's where the real magic happens. But hold on. How do I know what I'm getting when I'm shopping for new devices? Is it gonna say USB 4 Gen 3.2 on the box?
You'll want to check the specifications for sure. Manufacturers will typically indicate the USB 4 generation, letting you know whether you're getting the 20 Gbps or the 40 Gbps version.
Okay, so I need to pay attention to that. But there's something else I'm a bit confused about. They kept mentioning Thunderbolt 4 in the episode. I thought we were talking about USB 4.
They are definitely related. Thunderbolt 4 is actually built on top of USB 4.
Wait, so it's like a super-powered version of USB 4.
You could say that. It's basically a more rigorous set of requirements that guarantees you get the full 40 Gbps speed, plus some other bells and whistles.
So if I want the absolute best performance, I should look for devices that are both USB 4 and Thunderbolt 4 certified?
You got it. Not all USB 4 devices will meet the Thunderbolt 4 standards, so it's good to be aware of that distinction.
Oh, okay, that makes sense. So I'll need to check the specs, look for those certifications, and be prepared to shell out a bit more for the premium experience.
That's generally the case with new tech, but the good news is, even if you have older devices that don't support the full 40 Gbps, you're still good to go, right?
Yes, because backwards compatibility is key.
It's designed to work with a wide range of devices, so you don't have to worry about your tech investments becoming obsolete.
Well, that peace of mind is definitely priceless. In the ever-changing world of technology. But speaking of the future, what excites you the most about the potential of USB 4?
You know, for me, it's the potential to finally break free from all the clutter and confusion of multiple cables and connectors. Imagine a world where you can connect virtually anything to anything else with a single USB-C cable.
Yeah, like a universal connector for all our devices. That does sound pretty utopian. No more adapters, no more compatibility issues, just plug and play.
Exactly. Laptops, tablets, smartphones, monitors, external drives, and docking stations. The possibilities are endless. And it's not just about convenience. It's about efficiency, too.
Okay, I'm listening. How so?
Well, think about it. Less time spent fiddling with cables means more time for the things that matter, whether that's work, creativity, or just enjoying your tech.
You can definitely get behind that, but let's be real for a moment. Every new technology has its challenges. Are there any potential downsides or hiccups we should be aware of with USB 4?
Of course, no technology is perfect. One challenge we've already touched on is those varying levels of implementation. Not all USB 4 devices will perform equally, so it's crucial to do your research and make sure you're getting what you pay for, right?
Buyer, be warned. What else?
Well, with any cutting-edge tech, there's the cost factor. Early adoption often comes with a premium price tag.
So for those of us who aren't exactly rolling in dough, it might be wise to wait a bit for the prices to come down.
That's a sensible approach for sure. But hey, if you're eager to experience the latest and greatest in connectivity, then go for it.
You only live once, right? But overall, it sounds like the benefits of USB 4 far outweigh the potential drawbacks. It's faster, more versatile, and has the potential to really streamline our tech lives.
Absolutely. And as with any technological advancement, there's going to be a learning curve. But once you graph the nuances of USB 4, the possibilities are truly exciting.
Okay, so now I'm really curious. What can we expect to see as USB4 becomes more mainstream in the coming years? What's next for this game-changing technology?
Well, the most obvious trend will be a surge in devices incorporating USB4 dot laptops, smartphones, tablets, peripherals, you name it. As manufacturers embrace this new standard, we can expect to see it everywhere.
So pretty much every device we use will eventually have USB 4.i. Have seen laptops at the store with USB Type-C. I wonder if they were USB 4.
That is a possibility. With the trajectory and the increase in adoption, we can anticipate more USB 4 devices and the prices coming down, making it more accessible to a wider audience.
That's great news. And what about the tech itself? Will it just stay the same, or are there more advancements on the horizon?
Oh, the innovation won't stop there. We can expect to see ongoing development within the USB 4 ecosystem. New applications, features, and capabilities will emerge, pushing the boundaries of what's possible.
So it's like a snowball effect. The more widespread USB 4 becomes, the more incentive there is to build on it and make it even better.
Precisely. It's an exciting time to be following this technology.
It sounds like we're on the cusp of a major shift in how we connect and interact with our devices. USB 4 really does have the potential to revolutionize the tech landscape.
I completely agree. It's not just hype. There's real substance behind it.
So true. Well, it's been a fascinating exploration into USB 4.
It sure has.
I think the most important takeaway is that USB 4 is more than just a faster connection. It represents a fundamental shift in how we approach connectivity, with the potential to simplify and streamline our digital lives.
It's a shift worth embracing.
So until next time, keep exploring, keep learning, and stay curious.